5-1-bed is making airborne. Right now, we've got our C-28 is airborne. Such was the mobilization during the Second World War. Many of you remember Mattel or even Lionel, toy manufacturers. The Lionel Train Company didn't build model trains during the Second World War. One of their principal products was the belts that fed the 50 caliber machine guns aboard the B-17 and the B-24. Mattel Corporation, who we used to malign for the M16, actually built many other small metal parts that were used in weapon systems during the 1940s. The F-4U saw service throughout the Second World War and on into the Korean War, which was the first war for a separate Air Force. Flying for both the Navy and the Marines, the F-4U was used in that CAS mission, that close air support. On the island of Okinawa, it was originally restored, flown by Joe Tobel, our current pilot's father. An airshow in Columbia, South Carolina, flying near Owens Field. Joe suffered a oil pump failure and attempted to return to the field. He didn't make it. He literally crashed and burned right off the end of the runway there at Owens. He was escorted throughout this desperate attempt to return to the field by his son Jim and his grandson flying alongside him in a T-6. Well, Jim and Joe owned and operated the Tobel hydraulic accumulator business in Bamberg, South Carolina. That was Jim's baby. And he returned to Bamberg and continued to operate the corporation while he recovered all the parts and pieces of the Corsair and started a multi-year restoration effort. After a number of years and a whole lot of dollars, the Angel of Okinawa recovered and started to fly once again. Now here you go, taxing out for takeoff is our P-51 contingent. Favorite belt. It still sees air races at Reno. One of these airplanes that are over 70 years old are out there chasing around the pylons looking for a new speed record. But back to the story of Jim and Joe. This will be the airplane into the air. And as you can see, he flies it with his father's name still on the cockpit rail. Beautiful restoration, returning the aircraft to better than new condition. Several Sons of the Rising Sun are preparing to attack the Monroe Executive Airport. All right, here comes Joe in right now, and a dirty pass. He's got the gear hanging down. Look at the size of the flaps on this wing. That helps slow him down. Remember, he's going to land on the deck of the carrier. And you can see the tail looks extended. You also get an idea of how long that landing gear would be if those wings weren't bent. He's going to clean up the airplane and accelerate. And we'll clear the airspace here as we have a medevac flight that's inbound at this time. They get preference in any situation. Use this call. All right, Jim's got the airplane on short final now. He's got the gear down and locked. Got all the flaps hanging out. Don't need the tail hook this time because he's going to actually land on the runway. Check out the speed differential between a 300-mile-an-hour passes, and he comes over the fence there about 140, 150 miles an hour, and then decelerates to touchdown. Maybe about 120, somewhere in that area. Keeps the nose up. See that big tail swinging back and forth? This is a tail-dragon airplane, and it does not like to land. It goes straight. Got a little bit of crosswind here today, but not much.